Hi, I'm Emily Antushik, and this is Considerate Mapped. This summer, we'll be exploring school choice as parents and students consider alternatives to public school education for the fall. And this month in particular, we'll be considering charter schools as one of these options. In North Carolina, charter schools are part of the public school system, and as of the 2015-16 school year, there were nearly 160 in operation across the state. Unlike traditional public schools, however, charter schools require students to apply to attend, and students can apply from anywhere across the state to attend any one of the state's charter schools, meaning that there are no locational restrictions to apply. Using home zip code data, we looked at the distribution of students attending charter schools statewide and by school this month in order to determine if students were local to their charters or traveling long distances to attend. The map of student distribution by zip code shows higher concentrations of charter school students in areas around cities because of high student populations in metro areas and typically more charters. The real interest in this map is in the geographic spread of students who attend each school, which we can explore by filtering the map for specific charters. While we can't make judgments on exactly how far students travel to school based on zip code alone, we do find that some schools are more localized in terms of their student populations, and some host students from adjacent counties or beyond. A number of factors detailed in this month's article can impact a family's choice and suggest interesting topics for further study as we learn more about how choice works in charter schools. The second element pertaining to school choice and charters we wanted to explore is the distribution of charter students by grade level. Currently, charter schools appear to cater mostly to elementary age students, as is most easily seen in the bar chart that accompanies the map on the second page. The teal section of the charter bar is much larger than the other sections of the bar. Through exploring the bar charts of individual schools, we found the numbers of charter school students are not proportional to those in traditional public schools, overall or by grade level. Counties with the highest concentrations of charter school students can be viewed in the accompanying map by grade level, and this map shows the proportion of charter school to traditional school students. One of the main debates in the conversation about public school choice, and one that this month's maps begin to consider, is how much choice can and should a public system be able to accommodate. In a totally open choice system, parents would be able to choose the educational option they feel is best for their child, but would all families have equal options available? And further, if there were a totally open choice system, what control measures would we need to have in place in order to ensure quality across the entire system? We'll be talking about school choice as the summer progresses, and if you have thoughts you'd like to share about school choice and charters, please reach out to us with your thoughts on ednc.org.